Hi, I'm Tom, one of the developer advocates here at Grafana Labs, and in today's video, we'll be taking a look at dashboards in Grafana. We'll dive into what they are, how they can be used to visualize and monitor your data, as well as discuss the individual components that they're made of. So, what is a dashboard? Well, a dashboard is a set of panels that allows you to visualize the various pieces of information about your system, giving you the ability to monitor whatever metrics necessary to determine whether or not your systems are healthy and performing as expected, and perhaps more importantly, to alert you when there are issues. You can think of a Grafana dashboard like the dashboard in a car. There are a number of panels and gauges that each show you a visual representation of the various pieces of information being gathered by the car's sensors. These include the current fuel level, the speed of the vehicle, the internal cabin temperature, and more. It's also where you'll be warned of any issues the vehicle might have via warning lights, which indicate that there's something that needs your attention. All of this information is gathered by the various sensors inside the vehicle and then visualized on the dashboard to give you an at-a-glance picture of the current status of your car. Just like with dashboards in a car, Grafana dashboards allow you to take the metrics, logs and traces from your various systems and visualize them using panels to give you an overall picture of the system's current health and status. Unlike the dashboard in a car, however, Grafana dashboards typically make use of time series data to allow you to visualize information about your systems over time. This helps you identify changes, such as whether or not there may be a spike in CPU usage in the last hour, or if there's a rise in error messages being generated within your application. We said that a Grafana dashboard is made up of a set of panels, so let's take a look at the individual components that make up a panel. First of all is the visualization itself. Grafana offers a wide variety of ways to visualize your data, including things like time series graphs, heat maps, histograms, gauges, data grids, and more. You can think of this like the speedometer in the car. It's the visual component that portrays a particular piece of information. Next is the data source that will be used to power the visualization. Grafana currently supports around 150 different data sources as part of our Big Tent philosophy, which includes everything from simple CSVs to time series databases such as Prometheus. Once a data source has been chosen, the next component is the query. This is where you decide what data you'd like to visualize from your data source. For example, you may want to grab the average response time of HTTP requests for your web application from Prometheus, or perhaps retrieve a list of all error logs for your backend API from Loki. Each panel can have multiple queries, which allows you to represent different pieces of information within the same visualization, such as the response times for different endpoints in your web application. Finally, there are transformations. This is where you can take the data retrieved by your queries and transform it in some way. For example, you may wish to filter particular values or properties from the results, or you might want to aggregate the data in some way. Grafana offers a large number of built-in transformations to suit a wide variety of use cases, allowing you to represent your data in a way that works for you. Let's imagine that you have a server, and you want to monitor the current CPU load to ensure it's not running into any issues. In this instance, you may choose to create a panel with a time series visualization that uses a time series database as a data source, such as Prometheus. You can then write a query that will be used to extract information about the CPU's load over time so that it can be visualized as a graph within your dashboard. You can give the panel a title, specify that the units are percentages, set the minimum and maximum values as 0 and 100 respectively so that you'll always see the values relative to 100% usage on the graph. This panel can then further be enhanced by adding a threshold that will visually indicate when the CPU load is running a little too hot, for example, when it's above 80%. This threshold can be visualized on the graph in a number of ways, for example as a red area with a dashed line, so that it's clear when the CPU breaches this value. Though not strictly part of the dashboard itself, you can also configure Grafana to send you an alert when the CPU usage has crossed your defined threshold for a sustained period of time, allowing you to be alerted when there's something that may need your attention, just like the warning lights on our car's dashboard. You can also add annotations to panels to indicate events that may have occurred. These annotations can come from a variety of sources dynamically or can be added manually by clicking on the graph. For example, you may wish to indicate that at a certain time the server was restarted. Once you've created a panel to monitor your CPU load, you'll likely want to add ones for visualizing other pieces of data about your system, such as memory and disk space utilization, server uptime, application logs, and more. The sky really is the limit. Dashboards are at the heart of Grafana. And while there are many more powerful features that I haven't covered here, Hopefully this video helps you to understand the fundamentals and how dashboards within Grafana can be used to monitor your systems to ensure they remain healthy and operational. If you're looking for some inspiration and want to see what other members of the community are doing with Grafana dashboards, I encourage you to check out the Golden Grot Awards, where each year, members of the Grafana community submit their amazing dashboard creations, and a panel of judges selects the very best ones to be showcased at GrafanaCon. If you found this video useful, remember to give it a like. And if you have any questions, please let us know down in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date with all things Grafana, and with that said, I hope you have an awesome day, and I'll see you in the next one.